children, welcome to my class. Today we are going to read Comedy of Errors. Comedy of Errors is a play written by Shakespeare. Shakespeare was a well-known playwriter. He has himself acted in few of the theaters. So let us see what is this Comedy of Errors. Children, there is also an Hindi movie which is based on this particular work by Shakespeare. The name of the movie is Angoor. In this, actually, a set of two twin brothers get separated after an accident, and after a few years, they bumped into each other. Let us see what happens. There are two sets of identical twin brothers. So, how many sets, children? Two sets of identical twin brothers are there: Antipholus of Syracuse and Antipholus of Ephesus, and their attendants. Dromio of Syracuse and Dromio's Ephesus. Ephesus and Syracuse are the names of the places. Children, during their childhood, the brothers are caught in an accident at a sea and they are separated. So when they were yet children, they got separated because of an unfortunate accident. They got separated due to an unfortunate accident, and therefore they don't know each other. Years later, Antipholus and Dromio of Syracuse travel to Ephesus in search of Antipholus and Dromio of Ephesus. So, children, Ephesus is the name of a place. Now, Antipholus and Dromio of Syracuse, they travel to Ephesus in search of their brothers, because they knew that they had some twin brothers, and therefore they have come to which city? They have come to Ephesus. Now, Antipholus of Syracuse has asked his attendant Dromio of Syracuse to take his money and keep it safe at the inn as he looks around the city. So, children, Antipholus is the master of Dromio. In both the cases, Antipholus is the master and Dromio is the help. Now, Dromio is the attendant. Now, Antipholus of Syracuse has given some money to Dromio of Syracuse to take the money and to keep it in the inn, which is nearby. Okay, so now he has gone to submit the money. Dromio has just left to follow the master's orders, and Antipholus is alone. So, what did Dromio do? Dromio has gone to submit the money at the inn so that they don't lose it. These two have come here to this city of Ephesus in search of their brothers. A square in a business district. This is the scene which is happening in the square. Antipholus of Syracuse to himself. Dromio is a good fellow. He completely is trustworthy, and he often makes me laugh when I am afraid or worried. But nobody can cheer me up right now. I am like a drop of water that is looking for another drop in the huge ocean and is totally lost and confused. Until I find my brother, I can't rest easy. So Antipholus of Syracuse is appreciating Dromio. He is thinking that Dromio is a good fellow and he is quite trustworthy. That's why he has given his money to be submitted to at the inn. Why are so? Now enter Dromio of Ephesus. Now, who has entered, children? Dromio of Ephesus has entered. But because of the mistaken identity, because they are identical twins, Antipholus of Syracuse is thinking that Dromio of Syracuse has come. But in reality, he is Dromio of Ephesus. Why are you back so soon, Dromio? Dromio of Ephesus, back so soon? You should rather ask why I have come so late. The roast chicken is burning. It's 12 o'clock and mistress is hot. Because the food is getting cold, and the food is getting cold because you haven't come home. And you haven't come home because you are not hungry. And you are not hungry because you have eaten already. But you can always ask forgiveness for your fault today. Now, Dromio of Ephesus is thinking that Antipholus of Syracuse is Antipholus of Ephesus. So, it is a mistaken identity. It is a case of mistaken identity, that because they are identical twins. Antipholus of Syracuse. Stop, stop. Tell me, where have you left the money I gave you? Now, because Antipholus of Syracuse is thinking that he is talking to Dromio of Syracuse, so he is asking him, where is the money which I gave you to give? And Dromio of Syracuse is actually gone to the inn to submit the money, and the person to whom he is talking is Dromio of Ephesus. Dromio of Ephesus. The 6 pence you gave me last Wednesday, I used it to pay the mistress's saddler. Now he had given some 6 pence last week. On he has spent that money for something to buy for his wife. Antipholus of Syracuse, stop joking with me. I am not in the mood now. Tell me, where is money? We are strangers here. How dare you trust someone else with your responsibility? So now Antipholus of Syracuse is getting angry at Dromio of Ephesus. He is thinking that he has given his money to somebody else. Dromio of Ephesus, please sir, I have come in haste from my mistress. Now why has he come? Why has Dromio of Ephesus come? Because the wife of Antipholus of Ephesus has sent him to find him out, in search of Dromio of Syracuse. Please, sir, I have come in haste from my mistress. If I return without you, I shall be dead, because she will punish me for your fault. Like me, sir, your stomach should be your crock, and the alarm should send you home without a messenger to call you. So now he is saying that your wife is waiting for you at the home for dinner. That's why she has sent me. Now whose wife has sent? The Antipholus of Ephesus' wife has sent Dromio of Ephesus. But now he is not meeting Antipholus of Ephesus. He is meeting Antipholus of Syracuse. Come, Dromio, this is not the time to play the fool. Where is the gold I gave you? So now he is wondering that he has lost the money. Maybe he has lost the gold as well. So he is saying that this is not the time when we can actually play the fool with each other. Where is the gold that I have given you? Antipholus of Syracuse. Dromio of Ephesus. Gold, sir, you do not give me any gold. He is saying you did not give me any gold. Antipholus of Syracuse. Oh, come, you rascal. Stop being an idiot and tell me what you did with it. It was your responsibility. Now Antipholus of Syracuse is getting angry on Dromio of Ephesus. Dromio of Ephesus, it was my responsibility to bring you home to your house to lunch. My mistress and her sister are waiting for you. So now he is saying that your wife and her sister are waiting for you for lunch, and my gold was not my responsibility. My responsibility was to call you. Antipholus of Syracuse, where have you kept my money? I will wipe that cheerful smile off your face if you continue fooling when I have told you that I am not in the mood. What did you do with 1,000 marks I gave you to keep? Now, and they are not able to understand anything because they are talking because of this mistaken identity. Dromio of Ephesus, ouch! The only marks I have are on the ones on my head which you gave me now. Now he has given him one nicely. He has slapped him. Children, you can see the picture here. He, the Antipholus of Syracuse, has bitten Dromio of Ephesus. Your wife is hungry and is waiting for you to come to dinner. She begs you to come soon. Antipholus of Syracuse. What? How dare you keep talking nonsense when I told you not to? Take that, you. Dromio of Ephesus. What are you doing, sir? Hold your hands or I'll take my heels. I'll take to my heels means I'll run away. Now, it's the exit of Dromio of Ephesus. Now, Antipholus of Syracuse. My God, this rascal has done something with all my money. This say town is wicked, corrupt, full of cheats and swindlers. If that is true, I better leave the place quickly. I will go to the inn and look for the rascal. I am terrified that my money is not safe. Now, he is thinking about his money. He is thinking that he will go to the inn. Maybe either he has lost it or maybe he has given it at the inn. Exit Antipholus of Syracuse. Antipholus of Syracuse finds his gold safe at him. He also meets Dromio of Syracuse and scolds him for having played a strange prank on him. Now, whom did he meet? Whom he met? He actually met the Dromio of Syracuse now, and up till now he was talking to Dromio of Ephesus. Dromio is confused because he did not understand what Antipholus means. He was at the inn all along waiting for his master. In the meanwhile, Dromio of Ephesus goes back and tells Andriana, wife of Antipholus of Ephesus, what happened. Andriana is very upset, and along with Luciana, her sister goes in search of her husband when she runs into Antipholus of Syracuse. Now, who is married, children? Antipholus of Ephesus is married to Andriana. And she will now is what now there is another comedy scene in which Antipholus of his the wife of Antipholus of Ephesus will meet Antipholus of Syracuse, thinking that he is Antipholus of Ephesus. Children, we will study that in the next class. Thank you for listening.